Hi, I'm Sophie from RSC Education and I'm here in the RSC Props Department. Before you watch a production, either in the theatre or as a broadcast or live lesson, it's always good to understand the plot and the characters. This film tells the story of Macbeth. Macbeth and Banquo are generals in the service of King Duncan of Scotland. They're returning victorious from battle when they're met by three witches who make three prophecies. Macbeth will become Thane of Cawdor, Macbeth will become king, and Banquo's children will be kings. He's already Thane of Glamis, and the Thane of Cawdor lives, so this doesn't make any sense. Almost immediately, the witch's first prophecy comes true, and King Duncan makes Macbeth Thane of Cawdor for treason's capital confessed and proved to have overthrown the previous Thane. Duncan believes Cawdor to have been a traitor, and Macbeth worthy to take his title. Macbeth sends a letter to his wife, Lady Macbeth, about the witch's prophecies and his new title. She fears his nature is too weak and full of the milk of human kindness to get to the crown quickly and thinks she'll have to do it. She calls on the spirits and murdering ministers to give her strength. Macbeth arrives home and Lady Macbeth tells him they should murder King Duncan that night so that the prophecy can be fulfilled and Macbeth can become king. With Lady Macbeth's help, Macbeth frames King Duncan's servants as the murderers. Malcolm and Donalbain, Duncan's sons, flee to England for safety, with Donalbain saying, "There's daggers in men's smiles." Now king, Macbeth worries about the third prophecy, said to Banquo, "Thou shalt get kings, though thou be none." He sends murderers to kill Banquo in an attempt to secure his own position. At a banquet, Macbeth is haunted by visions of Banquo's ghosts in front of all his guests. Lady Macbeth tells the thanes that Macbeth is ill and that they should leave it as it grows worse and worse. Macbeth begins to worry and visits the witches again. They warn him, "Beware Macduff, a noble who has also fled to England, but assure him that none of woman born shall harm Macbeth, and he won't be defeated until Great Birnam Wood to High Dunsinane Hill come against him." Macbeth believes he's invincible. After all, how can a wood move to a hill? While Macduff is in England convincing Malcolm to fight against Macbeth, Macbeth has Macduff's family murdered. Macduff and Malcolm arrive in Scotland with an army to march against Macbeth. On their way to attack Macbeth's castle, they cut down branches from the trees in Birnam Wood to use as camouflage, holding it in front of them. When the wood moves, another one of the witch's prophecies comes true. As his enemies draw nearer, Macbeth learns that his wife has killed herself. And he says, "Tomorrow and tomorrow and tomorrow," and talks about the futility of life. He then faces Macduff in combat. Macbeth taunts Macduff and says, "I bear a charmed life, which must not yield to one of woman born." Macduff then reveals that he was born by caesarean section and kills Macbeth, fulfilling the final prophecy. Macduff arrives with Macbeth's severed head. He hails Malcolm, the new king of Scotland. Malcolm honours those who have fought alongside him against the tyranny of this dead butcher and his fiend-like queen. If you would like to find out more about the plot, the characters, or where to find more resources, please visit our website. There are details about the Shakespeare Learning Zone, which explores story, setting, language, characters, and performance, and has different levels for how much detail you'd like to go into. There's also an online teacher pack.